Video we are going to discuss about the pancreas and spleen. So if you see the head of pancreas, it is present in concavity of duodenum. So you know this is duodenum, right? So in the concavity like this, you are having head of pancreas. So head of pancreas is present in concavity of duodenum. Behind the head of pancreas there is infraduodenal part of common bile duct. Behind means dotted, okay? And behind the neck of pancreas, this is the neck actually, behind the neck of pancreas there is formation of portal vein. So think this as portal vein and this is the head. So here having common bile duct, portal vein, okay? And the tail of pancreas is present in linearenal ligament. And the pancreas is a retroperitoneal organ except the tail. So all the head, neck, body of pancreas is retroperitoneal, but the tail is not retroperitoneal because it is having a linearenal ligament. Linearenal ligament is present in tail of pancreas, so it is not a retroperitoneal. Now coming to relations of pancreas. The left gonadal vein drains into left renal vein. So first we need to see what this diagram, then we'll understand. So you can see here, this is the left gonadal vein. It is draining into the left renal vein. And the right gonadal vein drains into inferior vena cava. So the right gonadal vein will directly drain into the inferior vena cava. This is the inferior vena cava. But the left gonadal vein drains into the left renal vein. Next, the inferior mesenteric artery. The inferior mesenteric artery prevents ascent of horseshoe-shaped kidney. Okay, the left renal vein crosses the aorta. So this one, the left renal vein crosses the aorta in front, below the superior mesenteric artery. Compression of left renal vein in between the aorta and superior mesenteric artery is called nutcracker syndrome. So the nutcracker syndrome, the left gonadal vein gets dilated because it is here near to it. That is the testicular vein. So left pampiniform plexus get dilated. There is a varicocele, that is a bag of worms consistency seen. So whenever the rectal vein is compressed, it will lead to dilation of left gonadal vein, and that will lead to left pampiniform plexus dilation and also causes the bag of worms consistency. Now coming to the posterior relations of head of pancreas. So posterior to the head of pancreas, you can see clearly this is a head pancreas, this is the head. So posteriorly there will be a right renal vein and also inferior vena cava and left renal vein. So in this diagram also you can see actually this is the right renal vein. So here you'll be having head of pancreas like this. Okay, so posteriorly you have right renal vein, you have inferior vena cava, and also you are having a left renal vein. So even the left renal vein. Now let us see the relations of uncinate process. So in this you can see here, this is the uncinate process. So here we have drawn like a line diagram. So this is an uncinate process. Superior mesenteric artery and superior mesenteric vein crosses uncinate process in front. So you can see here, this is the superior mesenteric vessels. So they are crossing the uncinate process in front like this. Okay. Now coming to the posterior relations of neck of pancreas. So this is the neck region. Behind the neck there is a portal vein formation. So you know how portal vein forms? The superior mesenteric vein with the splenic vein joined together to form a portal vein. Sometimes even the inferior mesenteric vein may drain into the splenic vein. Okay. So behind the neck, in the upper part, the portal vein is present. Lower part there is superior mesenteric vein, right? So portal vein, you can see here it is written splenic vein plus superior mesenteric vein. So coming to the splenic artery. Splenic artery is present in upper body border of body of pancreas. So here like this over here you will be having a splenic artery. Coming to splenic vein, it is behind the body of pancreas. So posterior relation. Next, tail of pancreas. that is in linear renal ligament, contain maximum number of islets. So maximum number of islets are present in the tail of pancreas. And next you can see here, note that the superior mesenteric vein is anterior to uncinate process but posterior to neck of pancreas. This is very important point. As I already said here, superior mesenteric vessels crossing in front of uncinate process, but the superior mesenteric vein is posterior to neck of pancreas. It's posterior there. Okay, so now coming to blood supply of pancreas, the head, you can see the head, it is supplied by superior pancreatic or duodenal artery, which is in turn a branch of gastroduodenal artery. Okay, and you know gastroduodenal artery is nothing but coming from the common hepatic artery, right? Next, coming to inferior pancreatic or duodenal artery, which is a branch of superior mesenteric artery. So these are supplying the head, especially head of pancreas, whereas whole part of pancreas supplied by splenic artery. So neck, body, tail supplied by splenic artery. This is very important. So if you see, the pancreas is supplied by both celiac trunk and superior mesenteric arteries. How? Celiac trunk branches are right gastro, right pancreatic or duodenal artery, whereas superior mesenteric artery branches inferior pancreatic or duodenal artery. So now coming to Passeros triangle. So it is formed by junction between head and neck of pancreas. So you can see this is the head of pancreas, this is the neck of pancreas. So between head and neck junction here forms a Passeros triangle. So the junction between head and neck of pancreas, a junction between cystic duct and common bile duct. You know that here you will be getting a cystic duct, here you will be getting a common bile duct. So at this junction, and junction between second and third part of duodenum. If you draw a duodenum like this, the second part, third part. So here, this is also known as triangle of gastrinoma. Now coming to spleen. So we have completed pancreas. Spleen morphology, if you follow Harris dictum of odd numbers, it's like thickness 1 inch, breadth 3 inch, length 5 inch, weight 7 inch. So if you see, all are odd numbers. So spleen is related with 10, 11, 12 ribs, greater than 9, 10, 11 ribs. So mainly it is related with 10, 11, 12 ribs. The axis of spleen, if you see, it is the 11th rib is greater than the 10th rib. And next, coming to splenic notches, they are mainly seen in superior border of spleen. So in the superior border of spleen, there will be splenic notches. Convex surface is related to diaphragm. Visceral surface is surfaced to gastric area, renal area especially to left kidney, colic area for the left colic flexion. In the hilum of spleen, you can see a tail of pancreas. So coming to ligaments, there are three ligaments, gastrosplenic, linearenal, phrenic, colic. Gastrosplenic ligament is present in between the stomach and spleen, according to the name gastrosplenic, stomach and spleen. So they are derivative of dorsal mesogastrium, containing short gastric and left gastroepiploic vessels. Linearenal ligament, it is between left kidney and spleen. It is also a derivative of dorsal mesogastrium, mainly containing the splenic artery and tail of pancreas. Coming to phrenic colic ligament, it prevents a downward downward displacement of spleen. So it is called as sustentaculum lenis. So the phrenic colic ligament is extending from, extending from diaphragm to left colic flexure. So there is a clinical called double duct sign. This is a presence of simultaneous dilatation of both the common bile duct and pancreatic duct. So carcinoma of head of pancreas and preampillary tumors can be seen in this double duct sign. So by this we also completed the pancreas and spleen. Next we'll start with the renal system.